So on today's Gavin's Good News Vlog, we are talking about the documentary series, Surviving R. Kelly. Have you seen it? And also we're talking about the airline that is putting a rather novel twist on performing to passengers. No more sad songs, no more sad songs, no more. Yes, what's happening, folks? So welcome to another edition of Gavin's Good News Vlog. This, of course, is the place to come for all the best of positive, upbeat and happy news around. It's a slightly odd one because we're starting with R. Kelly. Have you seen the documentary series Surviving R. Kelly? I haven't had a chance to see it yet, but everyone who I know has seen it has said that it is it's pretty revealing and it's pretty damning. All these allegations of sleeping with underage girls, 14-year-old girls, having cults, girls not being allowed to leave the rooms and studios. And it sounds utterly horrific. But these are all allegations at the moment, and I thought that there was a really interesting comments from Matthew Knowles, father of Beyonce Knowles and the former manager of Destiny's Child, who said that he wanted to keep the group and the girls away from R. Kelly as much as possible because he just didn't trust what he'd heard from various people and various sources back then. This was back in the late 90s when they were, in their mid-teens, and they'd just started out recording, some of the Destiny's Child tracks, like, Bills, 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 I guess, around that sort of era. Most artists of that time from that R&B generation had recorded a track of some sort with R. Kelly because he was the man of the moment. And he had Bump and Grind, She's Got That Vibe, that song as well, man. Those were iconic hits. And, he's gone on to have amazing hits since then. The Ignition remix and, I Believe I Can Fly. Those tracks have been used in, they've been played in clubs all across the world. Doesn't look particularly great for R. Kelly at the moment, does it? All these people coming out and condemning him. Lady Gaga's removed one of her tracks that she made with him from streaming. This is a platform for positivity, and I want this to be, all about empowerment. I just feel people can speak out about this sort of stuff, because I guess previously you couldn't. It is worth mentioning that R. Kelly was acquitted of child pornography charges in 2008. He's such a controversial character at the moment because this documentary from Lifetime alleges so much about him. Do let me know what you think about this story. Is it right to condemn Kelly from all the allegations from that documentary? Are people like Matthew Knowles right to be saying he didn't want his girls anywhere near him back then? It's almost like making a judgment before anything has really kind of come out there. But of course, these allegations are so strong. You've got to take them really seriously, haven't you? Let me know in the comments below. I'd love to. And lastly, I think you might find this initiative quite a fun one. Garuda Airlines, an Indonesian airline, have decided to launch this idea where they bring music sets and singers to perform to passengers on their flights. So I think it's really cool. I mean, I honestly think, I think that this would actually be, it depends though, to be fair. If you're just like, if you've had a long day and you're jet lagged and you just want to sleep, then it's the worst thing ever. But in general, I think it's another little bit of added entertainment, isn't it? Getting serenaded to 35,000 feet in the air. So at the moment, this is only going to and from the capital, Jakarta, to Bali. It's a massive country, many islands. Getting from one place to another, A to B, does take time, so you've got a few hours between each destination. Bali's a huge destination for loads of travellers all around the world, but at the moment Garuda are doing it from Jakarta to Bali, and the sets last 10 to 15 minutes. It's sort of like, I guess it's an ideal time to sort of dip in and have a bit of, a bit of light relief, if you like. Don't know how popular it's going to be in the longer haul flights, because you just don't know what times and what time zones people are on. Southwest Airlines in America tried it, didn't go down too well. Yeah, this is just, I just think it's a bit of a disruptor, isn't it? Try and do something a little bit different. Try and add to the entertainment on board, because not everyone wants to just watch films or TV shows or read their book. I think a little bit of something alternative. If you've got the space and if you've got the opportunity to showcase someone, and that's what they want to do as well, they want to showcase up-and-coming talent from the region. If you're an up-and-coming talent, you could be spotted on a flight. So you never know, that might just be your chance to break it on an aeroplane 35,000 feet in the air. And that's it for this edition of Gavin's Good News Vlog. Let me know what you think about the Surviving R. Kelly documentary. Have you seen it yet? What did you think? And also, Garuda Airlines putting that band in the middle of the plane, playing mid-flight. Would that annoy you? Would that really piss you off? Love to know your thoughts on that as well. Hit us up in the comments below. As ever, like, subscribe, follow, hit the notifications bell, all the usual things. Be great if you can do that. This has been Gavin's Good News Vlog. Thanks very much indeed for watching. Until next time, stay positive, keep happy, and we'll see you again very soon. Had a good life, can you keep pace? Can you ride shotgun in the fast lane with your eyes wide shut? Tell me, do you have faith in me? Stay the whole night till you feel the sun rays. Can you
Forget everything your man saying, and let all of our pain be the champagne. Let me take the wheel from here and penthouse suite.